plague, evil against good.
Who is responsible? Satan?
I didn't say that. I don't know, but what I do know is that we are witnessing biblical events.
All right. Wanna talk plagues?
Yeah.
Let's talk plagues.
Okay.
In 1400 BC, a group of nervous Egyptians saw the Nile turn red.
Oh, God. Come on.
But what they thought was blood was actually an algae bloom, which killed the fish, which prior to that had been living off the eggs of frogs. Those uneaten eggs turned into record numbers of baby frogs who subsequently fled to the land and died.
Right.
Their little rotting frog bodies attracted lice and flies. The lice carried the blue tongue virus, which killed 70% of Egypt's livestock. The flies carried glanders, a bacterial infection which in humans causes boils. Soon afterwards, the Nile River Valley was hit with a three-day sandstorm, otherwise known as the Plague of Darkness.
Catherine.
During a sandstorm, intense heat can combine with an approaching cold front to create not only hail, but also electrical storms, which would have looked to the ancient Egyptians like fire from the sky. The subsequent wind would have blown the Ethiopian locust population off course and right into downtown Cairo. Hail is wet, locust leaf droppings spread both on your brain, and you've got mycotoxins. Dinner time in ancient Egypt meant the firstborn child got the biggest portion, which in this case meant he ate the most toxins, so he died. 10 plagues, 10 scientific explanations. Gotta wash up.